Welcome back, friends. In the previous session, we solved the example in Raoult's law regarding the two liquids X and Y. And in today's session, we are going to continue with the solved example in Raoult's law. So what we are continuing to solve is the same topic of states of matter, and we are discussing the liquid phase. Now, in the today's session, we have this question. Benzene, which is C6H6, have the benzene, we have benzene, which is C6H6. Then when mixed with the toluene is C7H8, because the structure of benzene is like this way. This is the structure of benzene, having six carbons, or in other words, we can draw the structure of benzene as carbon, then carbon, carbon, then carbon, then carbon, then you are ending with carbon. So double bond here, double bond here, double bond here, and then here there are two hydrogen in every carbon atom. This is how we can draw benzene. So it has six in every carbon it has only single hydrogen, just only single hydrogen, because of the covalence state of a carbon. So 1 2 3 4 bond in ko kila carbon ina hydrogen moja, so it is C6H6. But in toluene is sometimes called as methyl benzene, and toluene it is benzene attached with methyl. So carbon is sitas hapa, and this one will be C7. Then kwa sababu hydrogen hapa ishaondoka, so tutakubaki na hydrogen 5 plus these 3, tutakuwa na hydrogen 8. So when mixed with the toluene, they form a diluted solution at temperature. Lakini what we are saying ni kwamba 2 moles of benzene were mixed with 3 moles of toluene, and the total vapor pressure above the solution was found to be 280. Kwa hiyo, if 2 moles of benzene, case 1, we have 2 moles of benzene, were mixed with how many? With 3 moles of toluene, 3 moles of toluene. Then we are given the total vapor pressure above the solution is found to be 280 millimeter for Hg. This is case 1. But when 1 mole of benzene, now this is case 2, when 1 mole of benzene was further added to the solution, 1 mole of benzene was further added. So from here, if we add 1 mole, it would be 3 moles of benzene. But the number of moles of toluene remain fixed. So when 1 mole of benzene was further added to the solution at the same temperature, the new pressure was changed to 300. So the number of moles of toluene in case 2, number of moles of toluene remain 3 moles of toluene. 3 moles of toluene to add 1 mole. And then we are getting the total pressure to be 3 millimeter for Hg. Now the question is, calculate the vapor pressure of pure benzene and toluene. How can we calculate the vapor pressure of pure benzene and toluene? Now let's start with case 1. In case 1, you are given number of moles of benzene. Number of moles of benzene is equal to 2 moles. And number of moles of toluene is equal to 3 moles. So number of moles total will be equal to number of moles of benzene plus number of moles of toluene. So from there, number of moles total will be equal to 2 plus 3, which is equal to 5 moles. So I hope up to here we are together. And then from there, we calculate the mole fraction of benzene. Mole fraction of benzene will be equal to 2 divided by 5, which is equal to 0.4. And the mole fraction of toluene will be equal to 3 divided by 5, which is equal to 0.6. Now, as we have already known the mole fraction of benzene and toluene, and we know the total pressure, which is 280. We are saying that from Raoult's law, we are saying that pressure of benzene will be equal to mole fraction of benzene, then times pure pressure of benzene, and then pressure of toluene will be equal to mole fraction of toluene, then pressure not of toluene. Now, from there, we are saying that total partial pressure P total according to Dalton's law is equal to pressure of benzene plus pressure of toluene. You see, now pressure total will be equal to mole fraction of benzene, then pressure note of benzene, and then mole fraction of benzene, pressure note of benzene, plus mole fraction of toluene, pressure note of toluene, pressure note of toluene. So from there, what we are saying ni kwamba pressure total tumeshapewa hapa in case 1. So in case 1, hii equation itaishaje? Itakuwa 280 is equal to mole fraction of benzene. In case 1 ni kwa ngapi? 0.4. So it be 0.4 pressure note of benzene and plus 0.6 pressure note of toluene. This is equation 1. Or we can rearrange this equation to 0.4 pressure note of benzene plus 0.6 pressure note of toluene is equal to 280 as equation 1. Now from there, let's move to the second case in which 1 mole of benzene is added. So in case 2, in which 1 mole of benzene is added, that means number of moles of benzene would be equal to 3 moles, and number of moles of toluene would be equal to 3 moles. So from there, number of moles total will be equal to 60 moles. Now the same quantities we are calculating, the mole fraction of benzene will be equal to 0.5, and mole fraction of toluene will be equal to 0.5. So if we want to include these components in this equation, or in this equation to include the mole fraction, we'll get now 0.5 pressure note of benzene plus 0.5 pressure note of benzene of toluene will be equal to the pressure total now in this case it is 300 millimeter of Hg. So this is equation 2. Now solve equation 1 and equation 2 simultaneously. Solve equation 1 and equation 2 simultaneously. What will you get? So if you don't know, you go to mode, then you are clicking 2 times or 3 times, you are going to equation. Unknowns, we have only 2 unknowns. So A1 will be equal to 0.4. A1 is equal to 0.4, B1 is equal to 0.6, C1 is equal to 280, then A2 will be equal to 0.5, B2 will be equal to 0.5, and C2 is equal to 300. So we'll get X, which is P naught of benzene, is equal to how many? 400 millimeter of Hg, and Y, which is equal to P naught of toluene, is equal to 200 milliliter of Hg. So the question is very easy. Umeshapata vapor pressure of pure benzene and pure toluene. Kwa hiyo unaweza uka calculate na mwisho siku ukaja kupata majibu kama hayo. Now in our notes, majibu ya mwisho ndio yalikuwa haya. Unaweza kuona hii ni 400 na hiyo hapo ni 200. Are the final answers in our question. Now let's continue with another solved example, as we are going to finish the solved example in the part of our Raoult's law. Now in this question, we are given, calculate the mole fraction of benzene in a benzene toluene liquid solution that is in equilibrium at 25 degrees Celsius with a vapor phase that contains 62% of benzene. So now in this case, ni kwamba tuna vapor phase, that means vapor composition of benzene is equal to 62%, or vapor composition of benzene is equal to 0.62. That means vapor composition of toluene would be equal to 1 - 0.62, which is vapor composition of toluene is equal to, vapor composition of toluene will be equal to 1. Let I just clear this calculation. Would be equal to 1 - 0.62. So this will be equal to 0.38. This is the vapor vapor composition of toluene. Now we are given vapor pressure of pure benzene and toluene. We are given, so the pressure note of our benzene is equal to 28.41. millimeter of Hg, and no, this is for toluene, because the vapor pressure of pure benzene and toluene are E-op and E-op respectively. So this is for toluene, and the pressure note of benzene is equal to 95.1 millimeter for Hg. Now we are given, calculate the mole fraction of benzene. Mole fraction of benzene. So in this case, what we are given is the vapor composition. So if the vapor composition of benzene is this one, we can use it to calculate the pressure of benzene. What is the pressure of benzene? So what will be the pressure of benzene? In order to know the pressure of benzene, tutasema kwamba vapor composition of benzene is equal to pressure over benzene divided by pressure total. Vapor composition of benzene is equal to pressure of benzene divided by pressure total. And remember, pressure total will be equal to pressure of benzene plus pressure of toluene, pressure of toluene. So now, what I can do here in this case is that we know that pressure of benzene will be equal to mole fraction of benzene, then times pure pressure for benzene. And we know that the pressure of toluene will be equal to mole fraction of toluene, then pure pressure of toluene. So the quantity which is required here in our case, the quantity which is required is this one. So we are given this one and we know it. So for example, pressure vapor composition of benzene is equal to pressure of benzene, which is mole fraction of benzene pressure note of benzene divided by mole fraction of benzene pressure note of benzene plus mole fraction of toluene pressure note of toluene. Now the case come ni kwamba tuna hii hapa mole fraction of toluene pressure note of mole fraction of toluene, and we don't know it, but we know the mole fraction of benzene plus mole fraction of toluene is equal to 1. So in other words, mole fraction of toluene is equal to 1 minus mole fraction of benzene. So mole vapor composition of benzene will be equal to mole fraction of benzene pressure note of benzene divided by mole fraction of benzene pressure note of benzene, then plus 1 minus mole fraction of benzene pressure note of toluene. So since we have all of these quantities except mole fraction of benzene, we can substitute all of these quantities to get the mole fraction of benzene. We can substitute all of these quantities. There is no need of a multiplication, opening the bracket and things like that. We can just go directly here and say the vapor composition of benzene is equal to 0.62, then is equal to mole fraction of benzene pressure note of benzene. Pressure note of benzene is equal to 95.1, then divided by 95.1 mole fraction of benzene plus 1 minus mole fraction of benzene. This one will be equal to 28.41. So what we are doing here ni kwamba tutachukua 0.62, then this will be multiplied by this quantity 995.1 mole fraction of benzene. Opening the bracket here, we'll get plus 28.41 minus 28.41 mole fraction of benzene is equal to on the other side of the equation is 95.1 mole fraction of benzene. So if we are taking this 95.1 minus 28.41 minus 28.41, we'll get 0.62, then 66.69 mole fraction of benzene plus 28.41. This will be is equal to 95.1 mole fraction of benzene. Multiplying this to outside, opening the bracket. So opening the bracket, we'll get multiply this by 0.62, we'll get 41.34780 mole fraction of benzene plus multiplying 28.41 0.41 times 0.62, we're getting 17.6142 is equal to 95.1 mole fraction of benzene. So taking this to another side of the equation, 17.6142 is equal to 95.1 mole fraction of benzene minus 41.3478 mole fraction of benzene. So 17.6142 is equal to, taking the quantity 95.1 minus 41.3478, this should be equal to 53.7522 mole fraction of benzene. Now dividing by this both sides, you will get 17.6142 divided by answer, we will get a mole fraction of benzene is equal to 0.33. We can approximate it into two decimal places in order to be presented in an easier way. 0.33, it is approximation to decimal places, but in three decimal places mole fraction of benzene will be equal to 0.32 then 80 0.3276. So this is the final answer for our question, mole fraction of benzene in the liquid phase. So the question was somewhat confusing, but it is easier. So in the next session we will continue with the discussion on the vapor pressure mole fraction phase diagram for a DRI solution. Vapor pressure mole fraction phase diagram for a DRI solution. Thank you everybody, and let me wish you nice studies.